Good afternoon. You're with the big story here. I'm Seher Zama. And the big story is the top focus on the Aryan Khan bail plea hearing in the Bombay High Court. Let's get you those updates. Just ahead of this hearing of the bail plea of Aryan Khan at the Bombay High Court today here, Aryan Khan's legal counsel have categorically spoken here on this in distancing Aryan Khan from the payoff charge. This legal team here saying that they have no connection with the witness Prabhakar Sahail, who's turned hostile in this case with extortion charges that he's alleged against the NCB. Meanwhile, the NCB has also put in a counter. They continue to oppose Aryan Khan's bail plea. But this is an addition now that they've put in here, alleging witness Prabhakar Sahail, who's been influenced, and therefore this bail plea is ill-conceived. The former Attorney General of India, Mukul Rohatgi, has arrived at the Bombay High Court here. He is representing Aryan Khan in the arguments here today in connection to the Mumbai's drugs bust case. Let's in fact get in our correspondent Disha, who's getting us further updates, inside details of this bail plea hearing, of what more we have on these arguments here. Yes, Disha, please go ahead.
Well, that's right, Seher. In a short while from now, what we are being told, that the bail application of Aryan Khan along with the two other accused will be heard by the Bombay High Court. Just to give a bit of a background for our viewers as to what case really we are talking here about, Aryan Khan, the son of Shah Rukh Khan, has been inside the jail for the last 24 days. He was detained by NCB on October 2nd, and after questioning him for several hours, he was put under arrest on October 3rd, and ever since then he has been inside the jail. He had applied for a bail at the Sessions Court, but the Special Court had denied him bail last week because the NCB had put out a strong point saying that how he may be, there are WhatsApp chats as evidences to prove that, he possesses and he might be in a larger nexus of drugs for that matter. And that is why there are certain WhatsApp evidences which needs to be investigated further. So denying him bail won't be right at the moment. Then later, Aryan Khan went and approached the Bombay High Court, and the hearing has been scheduled for today. So after 3 p.m. is what we understand. The court will hear the matter, and now this particular hearing will become even more prominent and significant, Seher, because of the developments that we have seen in the last 3 to 4 days, where the independent witness has come forward and clearly stated the extortion angle over here. He also has revealed that how he was made to sign on 10 blank papers. He was made an independent witness in this case where he knew nothing. He was also asked to go and collect cash from one person. So right. Entire extortion bid angle also has come to light in this Aryan Khan drug case. So now what we understand, today's hearing will be very much significant because NCB today has opposed the bail plea of Aryan Khan, clearly saying that how if he releases on bail, then the witnesses might get influenced further. And NCB has categorically mentioned the name of Shah Rukh Khan's manager, Pooja Dadlani, that how, she has gone ahead and influenced the witness number one, Prabhakar Sahail, in this case. So all of this should not happen further. That is why he should be denied bail. So a lot of arguments definitely expected today by the NCB as well as Aryan Khan.
But Disha, that's very interesting what you've said here, that the NCB now is literally quoting what Prabhakar Sahail said on Shah Rukh Khan's manager, Pooja Dadlani, here. And in the same breath, the NCB also alleges here that this is a witness who's turned hostile and his claims are bogus. Prabhakar Sahail's statements cannot be trusted. So they're cherry-picking on Prabhakar Sahail explosive details basis what suits their argument.
Well, that is right, and that's indeed the move that the NCB has taken today, because remember, Aryan Khan had filed a bail application last week when his bail application was rejected by the Sessions Court on the very same day. So if NCB would want, they would have filed or opposed the bail plea within this 1 week's time, but they did not do so. They did today, and the you know, argument that they have put forward is of how, you know, the witnesses might get influenced if he's released on bail, because clearly Prabhakar Sahil in his statement had also mentioned Pooja Dadlani's name, that how she also met, you know, with one of the person with the NCB officials on the intervening night of 2nd and 3rd. So this particular statement coming now from NCB wants to, they want to prove their case really very strong is what we are, you know, picking up from what they have filed. But as far as Aryan Khan's team is concerned, they have also filed a rejoinder, Seher, to NCB's reply saying that he has no connection with either Prabhakar Sahil or his employer KP Gosavi, and his bail application should be clearly heard, you know, neutrally without having any external third parties involved.
That's right. But stay on with us here, Disha. We'll continue tracking those updates. Of course, the hearing to start a short while from now, where counter affidavits that have been put to this already. But we're getting in further breaking updates here.